Guys, welcome back to my channel here. This is your girl Sassy Dassy, and in this video I'm gonna be giving you a movie review. Oh wait, today is Wednesday and this is What's Up Wednesday. How y'all doing? Hey, but like I said, I'm gonna be giving you guys a movie review that was a Netflix original starring Nia Long and Omar Epps. Raise your hand if you've seen Fatal Affair. If you haven't seen it, pause this video, go watch it, and come back, because I'm telling you, this review is about to be spot on. Okay, but everybody else, let's just get into this review. Okay, so off the bat, I was a little apprehensive to even watch the movie because it was a Netflix original. I know it seems like some movies that go directly to Netflix are really not that great. So that's what I thought was going to be it. I don't know if it was just strictly the name of the movie, because by the name of the movie, you can already kind of tell what the movie is going to be in telling, or that it starred Nia Long and Omar Epps, and I have followed work that they have did in the past. But I decided to watch it. It was an okay movie, you guys. It was okay. What is this on my face? Okay, we good. It was okay. I'm not going to say it was like the best movie ever. I'm not going to say it was the worst movie ever, but it was okay. You have to be careful, because with these type of movies, it's something that we have already seen many times with different characters. Either it's a crazy man trying to get a woman, or a crazy woman trying to get a man. Well, in this case, it was a crazy man trying to get the woman. Blah, blah, blah. I'm going to be obsessed with you. And then somebody dies at the end. Pretty much the movie in a nutshell. So for me, you almost kind of got to go over and beyond and do things completely out the box to make it stand apart from any other movie that we have seen in this criteria. But like I said, it starred Nia Long, Omar Epps. So let's just kind of jump right into it. It opens up with a man and a woman getting killed. So then it jumps to Nia Long and her family. It creates the scenario that Nia is supposed to be leaving because they bought this new house on the beach so she can start her own firm. But she's going to be doing it after this case. Now, this case required some email type hacking, and that they contracted Omar Epps. Now, Omar has not seen Nia since like college. Nia remembers him from college. She's like, oh my gosh, how you been doing? Blah, blah, blah. It's so nice to see you. Now, Omar Epps had an obsession with Nia. Nia just knew him from college. So they was like, let's catch up. They end up getting drunk at a club and almost had a moment in the bathroom. Almost had a moment in the bathroom. And that kind of just like sparked the craziness in Omar Epps that I have to have her. So it starts with innocent text messages, innocent emails, calling, and then he can't get her. So then he goes and he gets close with Nia Long's best friend and then starts dating her. Then it goes further as he comes to her house unexpected as Nia Long's best friend dinner date. And Nia is just kind of petrified because she hasn't told her husband about anything. You know, she's been trying to like distance herself away from Omar Epps and just trying to forget about everything that almost happened in the bathroom at the club. But Omar Epps is obsessed. So, you know, things are kind of getting weird. Nia sees that he's not backing off. She's trying to figure out a little bit more about him and kind of sees that he has a little temper, that he has obsessive traits. And so she does her research and things are starting to come into play. Things are starting to come into fruition that she realized that Omar Epps is not the guy that everybody thinks he is. He's crazy. And she actually thinks that he killed his wife. You remember, let's flash back. You remember at the very beginning of this video, I said the movie started with a man and a woman getting killed. Nia feels that Omar Epps killed the woman, his ex-wife, and her new husband or boyfriend at the beginning of the movie. He has those obsessive traits, If I can't have you, nobody else will. So let's just kind of go ahead and get into it. So he's killing everybody. Friends, he's killing coworkers. He's killing people to get close to Nia. So, you know, he's then got to the house because, like I said, he's a tech guy, so he's able to break into their house, watching Nia sleep, getting, you know, watching her on the camera and everything. Now, one element of this movie that I felt that was really, really, really good, that if they would have ran with it a little bit more, could have really, really been good. Okay, so when stuff started getting hot, things started being figured out about him, and you know, like things were starting to come close to him. He found this homeless man and killed him, burnt him, but he portrayed it almost like if it was himself. So he almost like killed himself off, or made it seem like he killed himself off. So he did some little things to kind of lead them to think that he was the one that was actually found burned to death on the beach. He did some searches on his computer, like ways to commit suicide. He told his therapist, because he dealt with anger, that he was going to take responsibility for it all and that he was going to handle it. And then he also left a suicide note that kind of portraying like his name and da 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 da. So whenever they found this, they was like, yes, we're good, he's gone. I hate that it had to happen, but he's gone. But he wasn't gone. So long story short, he ends up getting into their house, tying up Nia Long's daughter and her husband, and actually kills Nia Long's daughter's boyfriend. For what it was, just almost kind of like no reason to really kill him, but I guess just to kind of ultimately show, like, I don't even care about anybody, I just want you. But it ends up being a struggle between Nia Long and Nia's Long husband and Omar Epps, and he ends up falling off the cliff and bye bye Omar Epps. And then it's just kind of like the end of the movie. It's kind of like every other like Fatal Attraction movie that I had, and I guess that's why I said it wasn't a bad movie. It just seems like a movie that we have already seen before, because they didn't really do anything out of the ordinary. But that one thing with the whole homeless guy, that was like kind of a different twist on it, just to like, you know, feel like he was gone, just to kind of just, you know, distract them for his ultimate big finale to try to get Nia Long. Like I said, it wasn't a bad movie. It wasn't a great movie. It's just something that we have already seen multiple times and everything. But like I said, for them with that type of plot, it's an easy storyline for you to do a movie off of. But for you to do a movie off like that, you have to come with some really, really different events and circumstances just to make it completely different from what we have seen before. But like I said, it's out there, it's on Netflix. I mean, it's an okay movie. It's some, if you want to watch something, it's something to see and everything. But hey, that's my little movie review. You guys, I am so close to 100 subscribers. I thank you guys so much for my support, for you guys' support and watching my videos and supporting my content. I have only been doing YouTube for probably about roughly about 3 months now, and I thank you guys so much for the support. We're so close to 100 subscribers, so if you are new to my channel, please watch my content. If you love it, like it, you know, please subscribe. I would love to have you join Team Sassy Dassy. But I hope you all have a great rest of your day. I hope you have an awesome rest of your week. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.